It's a bike ride that has raised more than $2.4 million to date, sending hundreds of kids with cancer to camp. Joining me is the founder of Ride for Karen, Karen's son Kris Tobias, and cyclist Andrew Randall, and we're going to talk about this incredible event this morning and how to train for events like this. So, Kris, let's start with you. You started this charity, I believe it was 2001.
Correct.
And yeah. It was for your mother, who had went through 5 years of breast cancer.
She went through 5 years of breast cancer. She fought very bravely, but unfortunately she didn't survive, and we wanted to give back and start a ride in her honor.
Mm-hmm. Did you ever think that this many years later you'd still be doing it, and it would be as big as it is, and raise as much money as it has?
No. I mean, I don't think you really have the concept of that when you start. I mean, I really started almost selfishly to help myself and my brother and my family feel better, find a way to put some meaning to what was for us a really tough loss.
Well, what's amazing is that, you know, like Camp Ooch, Camp Quality, Camp Trillium, these are all camps that have really benefited from this. You know, we're talking about, you know, letting kids go to camp and actually refurbishing and helping those camps out as well, right?
Correct. We're talking about all that, and we're even talking about programs in the city at Sick Kids Hospital, Ooch on the 8th, which is like a camp-like experience right in Toronto. So camp is really a state of mind more than it is a location.
Amazing. Well, I'm going to get you guys, I want to get you guys cycling here.
Yep.
Because here's the thing, with I mean, I'm looking at your courses. You've got a 200-kilometer course,
yes.
You got a 160 and a 100, and even 100 kilometers, Andrew, sounds like a lot. How do you get ready for something like this, because this is a physical challenge as much as there's the fundraising goals as well?
Yeah, I mean, the interesting part is the 200 kilometer course was made on request from some of the riders.
Really?
Yeah.
Because you just weren't pushing them hard enough.
Yeah, they just 160 wasn't quite enough, so they said give us 40 more. Yeah.
So how do you train for something like this?
Well, I mean, for many of the riders, you know, it's kind of like it's a pastime, right?
Mm-hmm.
So they're training pretty consistently throughout the year. But for some riders, we're working with some people, we're getting them ready in 6 weeks.
Wow.
So if you're somewhat fit and you're active, you can probably get ready in 6 weeks for something like this.
Now, what you guys are on right now, I think, is very, very interesting, and I don't know if we can get a shot of this. This is great for a city like Toronto, these machines that you guys run, because A, it's, you know, the weather is all over the place, and B, there's no real long, straight places to go if
That's
you're going
right.
to do really long and controlled training. So
yeah.
What are you on right now?
These are called rollers,
mm-hmm.
And yeah, they're fixed and sort of stationary and with a little bit of movement.
Mm-hmm.
But the idea is, with the indoor training, you know, there's a safety aspect in the city and nowhere to do the long segments. So a lot of people are moving towards training inside because it's very concentrated and very effective.
Now, do you guys do this in the morning and kind of like wake up and cycle before you get to work, or what's your training regimen?
Well, in the city, a lot of people will do an outdoor ride in the morning,
mm-hmm.
and then maybe sometimes during the week when they want to do something very specific, they'll do a quick ride in the morning on the trainer, yeah.
Amazing. Okay, so, Kris, before we have to go here, this takes place Sunday, August 13th. You can take part and donate at Karen.com. Is there anything else that we should know going into this event? Can you still sign up?
You can still sign up. You can sign up right till Saturday. We welcome anybody to go to the website, rideforkaren.com, sign up. And join us. If you can't join us, just donate. 100% of the proceeds go to send kids with cancer to camp.
Amazing. 100%.
100%.
Love that. All right, so the Ride for Karen takes place this Sunday, August the 13th. Again, so you can donate at Karen.com. That's a really easy one. Karen.com to donate. Thanks so much, gentlemen, for coming in. We appreciate it.